Hey YouTube, here's Heiko coming to you with another little product introduction. Reviewing would be a little early since this is the first time I'm using it. So here you see a 20 pound propane bottle, 10 foot long hose, and a Mr. Heater weed torch, which I bought at Tractor Supply today. You can find it online, Amazon, a little cheaper, but you know, our backyard was getting out of control here. Weeds growing everywhere, and I just wanted one. We have two dogs and three kids, and I don't want to spray chemicals around, so I figured this is the most effective non-chemical version of weed fighting, and works pretty good. Just wanted to show you real quick this contraption. He has a little handle, there's a valve, and then the burner in the front. Pretty simple, hooks up right into the valve on the bottle. It doesn't need any pressure regulator. I have a garden hose running, of course it's leaking, just in case something gets out of control here. I just water it right down. When you use something like this, you got to make sure that the propane bottle is always behind you and that you're always keeping track of your propane hose, because you don't want to light that on fire. That would be kind of a bad one. Anyways, when I first started using it, I was actually making a mistake. I opened the bottle, the valve on the bottle all the way, and then cranked open this here and lit it on fire. And I really had like a tiny little, you know, almost unusable flame. It was more like a, you know, like a little candle burning, nothing else. And then I actually looked at the user manual. If you crack that valve on the bottle open only like a quarter of a turn, maybe quarter to half a turn, and then turn the valve open here on the handle, you can already tell how much gas suddenly comes out of it. Yeah, and I'm gonna try to, you can actually just barely crack it open. And then they give you one of those sparkies here. It's like the same you use for. There you go. So this is the pilot flame. And now if I crack that open, I have my thumb on there. This goes quick. It goes really quick. I mean, it's not quite as cheap, not quite as quick, not cheap, quick as putting chemicals on the ground and then the chemicals work overnight kind of deal. You have to, you know, point it at each individual plant, but it's as permanent. So if you burn that down, pretty much what happens is the plant, even the roots get cooked, and then pretty much dies from that, and usually they don't come back. And it's very environmentally friendly. Of course there's a little bit of exhaust gases, burn, smoke from the plants, but at least you're not dumping tons of Roundup in the environment, and you know, your dogs don't grow any tumors a year later. That's why I was looking for this. Our kids run around here all the time. And I just did not want to put chemicals out. And then gotta be a little careful if you're around structures. You don't want to light your garden shed on fire. You know, maybe those two, three little weeds that are around the garden shed, you either have to manipulate with a weed whacker or just pull by hand. Pretty noisy, huh? That's the inferno of the flame. I mean, look at this. There's really not much messing about, but you gotta make sure you have your bottle in a safe place somewhere behind you. So you are always between the flames and the bottle, and your hose needs to be under control all the time. Sorry, my camera work sucks a little bit here, but I just wanted to show you this. So this is like a $50 weed torch made by Mr. Heater, same company that makes all those space heaters, those propane space heaters, or you know, and course, there are lots of different brands that you can buy on Amazon. You can find like 1,000 different offerings. I just picked this one because it was locally available and I just wanted to do it. Yeah, look at this. All burned up. Wherever you have gravel, where you have pavers, all that stuff can be easily cleaned up. All right, guys, you get the gist, you get the idea. It works really well. Make sure you keep your bottle safe. Do a leak check with a spray bottle of water and soap. And have a garden hose ready in case your backyard catches on fire. All right, guys, I hope you like it. Bye.